You're telling me that Google, an American company, supposedly, is refusing to work with the Department of Defense, but is doing work in China in a way that at least indirectly benefits the Chinese government. Is that correct?
The work that Google is doing in China is indirectly benefiting the Chinese military. We watch with great concern when industry partners work in China, knowing that there is that indirect benefit. And frankly, indirect may be not a full characterization of the way it really is. It's more of a direct benefit to the Chinese military.
General Joe Dunford, he is chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, shocking a Senate panel this morning with the news that Google is helping the Chinese military, even though last summer they announced that they were withdrawing from a U.S. military contract because its employees protested. When Fox News reached out to Google for a statement, we were directed to previous statements that said nothing about their work in China. So, folks, where is Google's moral compass here? What do you think?
Well, I think this is quite unimaginable, and I think Sergey and Larry should be put in front of this Senate committee with the chairman of Joint Chiefs of Staff and explain themselves. You know, without our security and our safety and our military, we have nothing. And just to think that they'd be doing something that helps the Chinese, but basically tell us, not for the U.S., I may have to find Microsoft Bing or Yahoo and use those search engines if they're still up at this point in time.
Yeah, well, that's just it. I mean, Google's whole model, don't be evil, I think you can extrapolate that. Don't aid evil. And David, I mean, for a company whose whole business is built on trust and privacy, I just can't imagine this isn't doing tremendous damage to their reputation, both with Chinese people actually in China and certainly with their American audience. And it comes exactly at a time which, interestingly, Facebook is positioning towards privacy. So I don't think we need Senate committees, but I think Google, by aiding the Chinese military, is really doing some serious damage to their reputation and their bottom line.
Well, and I think it also comes at a time when Elizabeth Warren and now several other people running for president are talking about breaking up these companies because of the monopoly power that they have. There is no company out there that has a bigger monopoly than Google. So it seems to me that they're a little bit vulnerable on the public relations front. Let's also remember, it's not just AI where Google is helping China. It's also on surveillance, all kinds of surveillance products, which, by the way, aids to the incarceration and following of more than a million Muslims in China. I mean, this is pretty appalling stuff, and I think Google really has a lot to answer for here.
It's funny, to Jonathan's point, it's no longer don't be evil, it's do the right thing. The motto changed when the company became Alphabet. But if we're talking about the connection with China, you have China, the actual government, owns $5 trillion of the Chinese economy. So Google's going to probably play the card that, oh, it was maybe an indirect benefit, but they must have known, given the government's influence. And I think David brought a good point up in the intro, too, about the fact that Google didn't want to go forward with that Jedi Pentagon cloud computing project worth $10 billion because it went against their corporate conduct, and yet they must know that there's some type of indirect benefit in China and to the military there, given the government influence.
Yeah. There should be a lot of pressure put on them. I would love to see wake up in the morning and front pages of every newspaper have this story, or the head of the network news each and every night. But you know what? I doubt it. I don't think we're going to see it. They're too ensconced with Trump 24/7, and this will probably go out of the news within a day or so.
Well,
something should be done.
We're reporting it, and of course, the Joint Chiefs of Staff, the chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, cannot be ignored. And again, he went beyond saying that it was sort of an indirect, innocent mistake that Google was making, saying that in some cases it was direct. I mean, he paused, said, no, it wasn't indirect, it was direct. Remember that what the 4,000 Google employees that were protesting the Pentagon contract said, they said, we will never build warfare technology, but apparently that's exactly what they're doing for the other side.
David, there's been rumors as well. I'll quickly say that Google has been working on search engine technology that essentially automatically censors those results for China's behalf. So, you know, to assist in repression, I can understand they don't want government contracts, but to assist in repression, you got to wonder what these Google leaders are thinking with this.
Yeah, and by the way, it's not like the United States is totally ahead on some of these technologies. On AI, for example, China last year published over 50% of of the important papers on AI, which was kind of viewed as a sign that they have leapt ahead of us in terms of technology. So, you know, maybe Google should just decide, okay, you're doing this on your own. We're not going to help you if we're not going to help America.
Well, it's quite a story. We're glad we could bring it to you today.